Hey there, scientist! We have a special guest today. Say hi to my friend Zeke. Zeke is leaving tomorrow to come visit me on Earth, but he doesn't know what to pack. You see, he lives on planet Zug, where the weather never changes. Every day when he wakes up, it is 75 degrees and sunny. Must be nice. You should have seen how surprised he was when I told him that here on Earth, the seasons change throughout the year. Since he is going to be visiting me on Earth for a whole year, I need to teach him about the differences between the seasons, specifically where I live.
I
Oh, good question, Zeke. How are the seasons different? Maybe this scientist can help us to figure it out and get you packed. Let's get started. Here on Earth, we have four seasons: winter, spring, summer, and fall. Each season lasts 3 months, and they gradually change or transition throughout the year. The changing of the seasons is one of the natural cycles here on Earth. A cycle is something that happens over and over again in the same order, just like day and night. Each season has its own unique set of characteristics that affect the way we live life here on Earth. Let's start by telling Zeke about winter. When you think of winter, what comes to mind? If you said snow, you're not alone. Some places on Earth experience extreme winters with tons of snow and below freezing temperatures, while other areas experience more mild winters with no snow at all. No matter what type of weather you get, winter is always the coldest season on Earth. During winter, people often enjoy sledding, building snowmen, and warming up with hot chocolate. But remember, if you head outside, you will need to wear warmer clothes like coats, scarves, hats, and mittens. Just like humans, plants and animals are affected by seasonal changes too. Plants have a special kind of sleep they go into during the winter. When it gets really cold, many plants go dormant. That means they stop growing and their leaves might fall off, but they're not dead. They're just saving their energy. Similar to plants, some animals, like bears, go into a deep sleep or hibernate during the winter too. Now that we've taught Zeke about winter, let's help him out by selecting the clothes he will need to bring with him for the winter months. Which set of clothes do you think he needs to spend time outside in the winter? I agree. These clothes will definitely keep him warm. As winter comes to an end, Earth begins to transition to the next season, spring. How do you think spring is different from winter? Spring typically has warmer temperatures than winter, but the weather can often be unpredictable. If you don't mind getting wet sometimes, spring is a great time of year to spend in nature. In the springtime, people plant in their gardens and begin spending more time outside again. You may notice people wearing different layers of clothing to stay prepared for unexpected weather. For example, you might wear a jacket over your shirt in case it gets chilly, or you might bring a raincoat in case you get caught in a spring rain shower. All of this rain and warmer weather is great for all living things. When the weather warms up above freezing, plants come out of dormancy and begin growing again. Lots of baby animals like chickens, deer, and bunnies are born in the springtime too. Now let's look at Zeke's clothing options. Point to the clothing you think Zeke should bring for spring with all its unpredictable weather. Perfect choice. Those layers will keep him prepared for the wet spring weather. As spring comes to a close, the days get warmer, the sun stays up longer, and people spend more time outside. After spring, we transition to... That's right, summer. Summer brings much warmer weather. Depending where you live on Earth, you may experience very hot weather, or you may experience more mild, warm weather. No matter what, we dress differently in the summer months. Typically, people wear clothing that will help keep them cool, like shorts, dresses, and even bathing suits. We also find activities to stay cool outside during the summer, like swimming or enjoying an ice-cold popsicle. When summer is at its hottest, animals may lower their activity levels and find shaded shelter to save their energy. All right, Zeke, let's see what you should pack for the hot summer days ahead. What do you think, scientist? Those clothes are the perfect choice to help him stay cool. Great job! Once the summer days begin to get shorter and cooler, that means the transition to fall is beginning. As the fall months arrive, you will notice the temperatures begin to lower. Fall is cooler than summer, but still warmer than winter. It will also be much drier than springtime. In the fall, people enjoy spending time outside on picnics, visiting pumpkin patches, and even going apple picking. Similar to spring, people will dress in layers to make sure they are prepared for different types of weather. Sometimes you might want a jacket and a scarf to keep you warm on a cool fall day, but sometimes you'll only need a light sweater. For plants, fall is a busy time. To get ready for their dormancy in winter, many plants stop making chlorophyll, which is what makes their leaves green, and all of their leaves change color before dropping to the ground. That's why you see yellow, orange, red, and brown leaves during this time. Dropping their leaves allows plants to save their energy for the upcoming winter. You will also see some animals, like squirrels, gathering and burying nuts. They do this so they have food to eat during the winter. Pretty cool. Let's take a look and decide what Zeke should pack for fall. I agree. Those layers will be perfect for the cooler fall weather. So, Zeke, let's review what we've learned about seasons on Earth. How are the seasons different? We learned that they are different in many ways, but the biggest difference is the weather. Between the cold of winter, the rainy days of spring, the hot days of summer, and the cool, crisp days of fall, you have a lot to look forward to all year long. Thanks to this scientist's help, Zeke, you are prepared to face all of the changes Earth seasons bring. Thanks for your help today, scientist. Remember, science is all around you. Hey.